Hey folks, Mike McAllister here, longtime WordPresser, designer, and developer. Today I'm super excited to share with you a brand new tutorial series called Build with Ollie, where I show you how to build beautiful websites with the new WordPress site editor. Now, WordPress has gone through some pretty big changes over the past few years, and one of them is the transition to block themes. Now, instead of building your site with code, you can use the new site editor to build your site with blocks, pattern designs, and a fully customizable design system. Now, while all of these new design tools are a huge win for users, it does mean that you have to spend some time learning how all of these features work together. But hopefully I can help you with that with these tutorials. I've been working on my own block theme called Ollie, and it brings together all of these powerful features into a beautifully designed theme. If you head over to olliewp.com, you can learn more about the theme and download a copy to follow along with this tutorial and the ones we do in the future. To get started, I want to keep it simple and show you how I built some of the pattern designs found in the Ollie theme. And by showing you how I created these patterns, you'll learn how to use the various blocks and design settings available in the new WordPress editor. So without any further ado, let's hop in there and create a pattern. Okay, so for this tutorial, I'm going to be using the Ollie block theme. You don't have to use it. You can use, whatever theme you want, as long as it can work with the WordPress site editor. But I will be using the Ollie theme because it comes with all of these nice base styles that have responsivity and everything else built in. So if you want to grab the theme, go to olliewp.com and you can click download Ollie for free. And currently it's just available on GitHub. So you click download Ollie on GitHub. And you can either download it up here or you can come over to the initial release and grab the zip here. And then you just install it into WordPress like you would any other theme and activate it. All right, so I want to show off how to build a WordPress pattern or show you how I built one of mine in Ollie. And so let's go ahead and grab a pattern. I'm going to click the plus here and let's go with this one. This is a nice one because it's pretty simple, sticking with kind of a more typography based one, but there's a lot of little bits and pieces in here that we'll learn while creating it. So I should also say, I'm not going to go over every single thing here. The idea is to kind of to move through this design quickly and kind of you can get an idea of the different tools I'm using to do it and then using the different settings throughout. So let's hop in and see how quickly we can recreate this pattern. So I'm gonna hop over here to a blank page. And so just to get started here, I can tell the first thing we're gonna need is a group to kind of contain all this stuff. So I'm gonna do a group, and I'm gonna do a single. And then within that group, we're gonna need some columns. Okay, and we'll do two columns. Now I'm gonna pop open the list view because this is just kind of a critical thing for me, at least when I'm building in the WordPress site editor, because then I know exactly what I have selected and it just makes it a lot easier for me to move quickly. Okay, so on the group here, I'm going to flip back over here and you see I want this to go full width. So what I'm going to do there is click on this alignment and select full width. And we also need a gray background. So I'm gonna click over here, go to background, click the background, that looks good. And if we flip back, we can also see we're gonna need a good amount of padding here. So I'm going to scroll down to the padding. I wanna unlink it so I can just change the top and bottom. And I'm going to go like that. All right, so we're starting to get a container going here. I'm gonna click down to the columns. Now we want these columns to be stretched wide to a wide width. So I'm going to select wide width there. And okay, we got our columns there. So let's start building out this side here. I'm just going to copy some of this text so I don't have to type it all out. Okay, so first thing I'm going to do is do some text, explore Ollie, and I'm going to paste that in there. And let's go ahead and grab that like that. So that's good. Now let's get this colored like it should. So text, I'm going to make it purple. Appearance, I think I did medium. And this I'm going to convert to a heading. And we can switch over there and see that that's looking pretty good, like it should. All right, now let's move on to the section down here. I'm going to group this for now. and you'll see why later. And I'm gonna insert something after that, and I'm hitting, on Mac, I'm hitting a shortcut Command Option Y to do that. And I know I need a separator, and I'm gonna choose dotted, and I'm gonna change it to this color here. It's just really subtle. And I'm gonna hit another, add another thing here, and I'm gonna add another group like that. And got my stars in there. And let's grab this text and grab this text. Okay, looking pretty good. Now let's style it up. We'll make this text purple. We'll make this, just change the appearance on it to make it a little more bold, make it medium. And then this was a smaller font and the text color was a lighter gray. So let's take a look here. Now we can see that this, the spacing in between these is not matching here. This is kind of too much spacing. So that's why we group things, so that we can go in here and select the group and then go over to the settings and the block spacing. And then we can drag this and you can see that it spaces out evenly all of the elements in that group. So I think we're gonna go with small. Okay, let's look. Okay, this is looking pretty good, except that I see here there is more space between this section and this section and the divider. So what I'm going to do there is, because I grouped these elements, you can see I have the containing column, and then I have a group, and then the separator, and another group. So again, what I can do is go over to the block spacing and turn that on. And then I can do the same here. See, I can change the spacing so that it is even. And so I think that was probably this, right? Yep, that's it. So that's it, that section's good. Let's go ahead and hop over to the next section. So we're going to build this purple box now. So I'm going to add another group here, a single column. And we'll make some text. I'll paste that in there. And let's go ahead and add some styling to this right away. Okay, we're gonna make that purple. The text we'll make white. We'll add some padding. We'll just kind of use the slider here to add some padding. I think there's maybe a little bit more, yep. So we'll just add a tiny bit more. Okay, so we're looking pretty good so far. Let's build this little section here. Now this is going to show you how to use the row block. So, you know, with the group block, when you insert things, it's cascading vertically. But with the row block, so if we go like this, there's a few different ways of doing this. You can type in row, you can use the group block and then change it to row here like this. And what this does is allow you to add items in line, basically, and it gives you different spacing options. So I'm going to click download with Ollie, and then I'm also going to add another thing there. And it looks like I had some text that said version 1.0. I'll make this bold. Let's see, what did I do there? Okay, so that was a little bit bigger. So let's change that to medium. That looks good. Okay, but you can see we have a problem here. You know, on my design here, this is spaced out and we have like a space between kind of thing here. So we can do that with the row block. We just make sure that this is selected. And then we go over here to justification and we click a space between items. And so you can see we've added that. Okay, so next I need a spacer before this, so I'm gonna add another divider. Whoops. Separator, that's what it's called. And we'll go dotted and we'll make it just a nice subtle color like that. So we're coming together here. We need a button and some text. So we'll do a button. And we'll make the button, what did it say? Download now. Okay, we'll change the background to white. We'll change the text to purple. We will make the width full width. Looking good. And then we had some more text, I think, download on something like that. We'll center align that. And this would just be a text link. So we'll go like that. And then what we can do is change the link color here. And looks like it was a smaller font. So we'll do that. Small. And look at that. We're pretty close. There's a few small details though. We need a rounded corners on this here. So I'm going to select the group. And the reason I put this in a group and just didn't put it right into the column is that the column, if you go here, you can see it doesn't have a border radius setting. But the group setting does. You can see there's a radius there, so I'm going to put 5 on it. So now you can see we have a nice round corner there on those. What else do we got to do here? It looks like this needs to be horizontally or vertically aligned, these two sections here. So we can do that. And we'll click on columns. And what we can do is you can see it's aligned top, we'll align middle now. And it just kicked it slightly down so that it is vertically aligned with the next box. And it looks like one other thing. So there's some less spacing here than there is in our design. So again, what do we do here? We just go, we click the group block, we go over here to the block spacing, and we just adjust as needed. So you can see I'm just gonna make it small, and that is it. Oh, one more thing. We need some space, more spacing between these two columns. So what I can do there is I'll click the columns block here. And very similarly, all I'm doing is going to go and click block spacing. And then instead of the vertical spacing we've been seeing, we can add horizontal space here. So you can see by moving this, I can add more space between the two columns. And with that, it looks like we have a perfect match. So that's it. I know I kind of sped through that and it kind of looked really quick, but it just is, these are meant to show you how all of these little design tools and all of these settings work together and how once you kind of master them, you can move quickly and build kind of whatever's in your brain. You can get it out and onto the page really quickly. It does take a lot of tinkering and it does take some just making sure you're kind of, you know the settings. But once you do get it, it looks great and you can build fast. And also, one thing to note is that we didn't have to do anything responsively to make it scale down. Ollie, the way Ollie's built particularly, is that all of the elements do scale down nice and gracefully. You can see our typography scaled down, the spacing between items, the padding, everything kind of just magically scaled down. And that's because of the design system that we've set up in the Ollie global styles via the theme JSON file that's in the theme. So if you use a theme like Ollie, you kind of get that for free out of the box. You don't even have to think of it. And that's just one of the other great features about block themes. So I hope this was helpful. I'm going to do several of these at least with patterns just to show you how to build different, more complex layouts because there's all kinds of things to learn and all kinds of little tips that are not super obvious. So I hope this was helpful. Stay tuned for the next one. Check out ollywp.com for the Ollie theme and check out the Ollie blog as well where I'll be posting all kinds of new content like this, tutorials, etc. So, all right. Thanks for hanging out with me for a bit. We'll see you next time. Thank you.